Yeah. So, we want to talk about one serious thing tonight. So it's all party except this. Surely it has passed no one by that there are things going on in the world that are beyond our control to a large extent, and that our brothers and sisters on this continent are suffering. So that is why, so you remember I told you before that we are an immensely expensive band. And that is why we have decided to donate every penny of the proceedings of tonight to humanitarian efforts in Ukraine. Wait. So there's more. So not only that, but the leadership of the university has generously committed to committing the same sum of money that we are getting paid. So twice, basically, our wage. And that is not it. So I welcome Brahe, Djäknar and Florakören up on stage. So we're gonna need your help with this. Thank you so much for being here. So, so these guys are students. So they're probably poorer than us and than most of you. And they have also unanimously agreed to donate every proceed of every gig they have done tonight. And they have done three to this cause. And we will now welcome you all to do the same and join us in this. And you will find out how you can participate in this in just a minute. But before we do so, so you know there's an EU initiative to offer study places to students, Ukrainian students who have had to flee their country. So Olena, will you please join us on stage? So this is Olena Holovchenko, and she is now a student at my department, the Department of Psychology at Åbo Akademi. And she would like to say a few words to you.
Hi. Hi, everyone. Thank you. First of all, I would like to say for you that it's a big honor to stay here tonight in front of you. Thank you for this. I would like to introduce myself and tell a bit of my story. So, as you already heard, my name is Olena Holovchenko. I'm from Ukraine. And my hometown is Kyiv. I think all of you know this city. Maybe someone even visited. This is city of my heart, and it's very beautiful one. As beautiful as the whole Ukraine is. But as we see, unfortunately, not for everyone, beauty, freedom, peace, humanity, morality and honor have some significance. On February 24th, I was at home in Kyiv, and I woke up at 7 a.m. from the words of my father, and it sounds like, "Hey, Lena, get up. The war has begun." It was the hardest sentence which I ever heard from him. And from waking up, I didn't understand what was happening. I thought that maybe it's such a bad and not funny joke, but it wasn't a joke. Apparently, every Ukrainian said to him or herself at that morning that it cannot be real. In the 21st century, it's something surreal. Like, it's a mistake or a nightmare. But after plenty of times of closing and opening my eyes, I felt worse and worse. Nothing changed. And then I heard the sounds of air sirens and looking for the nearest bomb shelter and realized that it's a horrible reality. I would never ever wish anyone to feel the same what me and 40 million of Ukrainians felt in the morning on 24th. Never. But here and now, I want to show you one video which will help you to get to know our feelings, which we had and we have, our Ukrainian spirit much better, I hope. So let's see.
Air raid sirens at the road. Strangers, they hug you in the doorway.
Mom writes, the third day they didn't eat.
What if tomorrow you or I die? That's weird. There is no fear. We have armed forces, we have volunteers, we have civilians obsessed with the courage. We have enough love and pain to share with the car. That's weird. There is no fear. Our culture stands against aggression. Our nation has no depression. Each owns either a machine gun or a laptop and clicks with it. Sounds of shock. We were not prepared for this war, but always standing against Russia as weapons flows in our blood. In the genetic code, in our peoples and faces, in the language, in each and every word. Not you, neither me, will die tomorrow, I promise. I'll come home, I'll go to the streets, and I'll sing a song. That, after this war, I truly know you. Ukraine, I'll renovate you to make the whole world to fall in love with you.
Thank you. By this video and next performance, I want to be heard, I want to be felt, I want to be understood. Today, I want to say my words for all those who have lost loved ones, lost their homes, lost their future, who are at risk of losing everything they love. I want to let you know that any your attention, your concern, and even slightest the contribution is all the hands you reach out. And we are, all Ukrainians, holding on regarding it, climbing by the mountain and going to victory. I want to make it clear that each of your positive vibration towards Ukraine, whether action or word, is a hope and understanding that we are not alone. With us, the whole world. We have someone to fight side by side. We won't forget any your help and way to support. Never. Because here is the one important things to remember. When we are united, we are stronger. And that's how we can defend freedom and human rights from the army of zombies. Thank you.
We'll be right back. It's not me, it's not my family. In your head, in your head, they are fighting with their tanks and their bombs and their bombs and their guns. In your head, in your head, they are crying. In your head, in your head, yeah. Zombie, 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 hey, hey. What's in your head? In your head, yeah. Zombie, 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 hey, 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 oh.
Silence, we must be mistaken. It's the same whole theme since 1916. In your head, in your head, they are fighting with their tanks and their bombs and their bombs and their guns. In your head, in your head, they are dying.
So we will take now a quick break, 5 or 10 minutes. This is how you can help. So your proceeds will go to Doctors Without Borders, which is a fantastic organization, and your money will really do some serious good. Thank you.